Hi friends, in this session we will discuss the perfect number concept. That is, we have to find all the perfect numbers in the given range using command line arguments. What is the perfect number? We already discussed the concept of perfect number. Here the perfect number is sum of factors of a number. Sum of factors of a number is equal to the given number. Is equal to the given number and exclude that number. Remember the point, exclude that number. That is, for example, 6. What are the factors of 6? 1, 2, 3, 6. But we have to exclude the number. See, and these are the factors of 6. What is their sum? Their sum is 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. So 6 is a perfect number. Now we are implementing this concept by using command line arguments. I am opening a file. So I am using in this path program name perfect.c. Perfect.c. I am implementing the program hash include stdio.h void main of. Void main of. Now we want to use command line arguments. We have to pass arguments to the main. We have to pass two arguments. One is the count, that is argc. It specifies the number of arguments we are passing. Second one is argv of a vector, that is its points to the, it is simply a pointer that points to the information what we are passed. It is a vector argv of. Program, our concept is we have to find all the perfect numbers in the given range. So I am reading, declaring two variables. One is start, another one is end. Between start and end, I have to find the perfect numbers. What is the value of start and what is the value of end? The value of start is the first index what is passed through command line arguments. So the first index, because the in 0th index is placed in name of the file. Similarly, the second index passed is end value. That is between, so for example, 1 to 1000. Start is the 1, end is the 1000. But here argv of 1, argv this vector is of type character. But here our start and end are integers. Now our aim is convert this character type into integer type by using the function a2i. It is a predefined function to convert the character into integer. Okay, now repeat a loop. Why we are repeating a loop means we have to find all the perfect numbers in the given range. Range means starting with start up to end. I is equal to start, I less than or equal to end, I plus plus. Now with the loop, step by step pick one number, find all the factors of that particular number. Here our number is I. How to find the factors of a number? The factors of a number is, for example, assume number is 10. 10 is divided with 1, remainder is 0, 1 is a factor. Now 10 is divided with 2, remainder is 0, 2 is a factor. 10 is divided with 3. Remainder is not 0, so 3 is not a factor, ignore. 4, not a factor, because 4, 10 mod 2, remainder is 2, 5. So when a number is divided from 1 to that number, if remainder is 0, that is a factor. If remainder is 0, that is a factor. And observe one point, for any number, from half of that number, there is no factor. For example, number 10, the maximum factor is 5. Because we are excluding that number. In the perfect number logic, we are excluding that number. That's why the maximum factor is only half. So for that purpose, for j is equal to 1, to find out the factors, j less than or equal to, what is our number? Here our number is I. J less than or equal to I, perform up to half because number 36, the maximum factor of 36 is only 18. So I am repeating the loop up to half only to reduce the number of iterations. And J++. In the loop, if our number is I mod I, the number is repeatedly checked with J. 5 mod J is equal to 0 means J is a factor. According to perfect number logic, if a factor occurs, perform some operation. To perform some operation repeatedly, I am using a variable sum with initial value 0. Sum is equal to sum plus what is here factor? Our factor is J. So initial value of sum is 0 because to repeatedly perform addition operation. For addition minimum we require two variables. So 0 is the additive identity. So I am using 0 sum. This loop is completed. The completion of this loop means we are finding all the factors for the particular number I. And whenever a factor occur, I am performing addition operation. After completion of the loop, if the sum we are getting is equal to our number I, then that is a perfect number. Printf percentage D comma I. Observe the point in the if condition. If condition is not satisfied, simply ignore the case. If condition is satisfied only, I am performing addition. This is a simple if case. So repeat the entire operation from start to end and close one. Save the program and build it. Observe, we have to declare the variables. So the variables are I, J, sum. How to declare? Save it. So we have no errors. Whenever it doesn't have any error, open command prompt. So in suppose I am in C drive. What is the path? The path is C, TC, bin, TCS. So CD space, TC, bin, TCS. In this, our program is perfect.exe. I am already executed the program. Now I am compiling the executed program. How we are passing command line arguments in this way? 1000. This perfect.exe is stored in argv of 0. This 1 is argv of 1, 1000 is argv of 2, that is 1 is the start, 1000 is the end. Press enter. Observe, these 3 are the perfect numbers. Within the range from 2000, these 3 are perfect numbers. This is the logic of perfect number. Thank you.